it's just as important that we implement an effective process as it is that we sustain it over the long haul. Many of you in here who are in leadership positions now will move on to higher leadership positions in this organization or will move on to other opportunities. And we need to know that the system can support itself, that the system is sustainable over time and isn't vulnerable to staff turnover and leadership changes and all the other things that can occur that can throw an important initiative off track. So we're going to look at today, what are some of the elements to guiding change and supporting change that can help make it sustainable over time. So there's five critical elements to managing successful change, and they're listed here on top, and they're also in your handout that you have. There's vision, skills, incentives, resources, and an action plan. And when all of those elements are in place, we usually see evidence of it by the successful launch and maintenance of an initiative. When any one of these elements is missing, there's a very predictable outcome or consequence to that. So when we think about vision, that usually comes down from the senior leadership level. And every time we do one of these workshops, we ask for senior leadership to kick off the meeting and cast the vision. So that's what Brian was doing this morning, was to cast the vision for the organization. You had a few different people speak to that vision today. But just as important as it is for them to cast the vision here for you today, it's equally important that when you go back to your facilities that you cast the vision for them. So you guys are bearing the torch when you go back to your facility and sharing with them the why behind the what. Why does this matter? Why does this matter to us financially? Why does it matter to us from a mission perspective? What are we doing here in this community? Are we here just to make money, or are we here to support the members of our community and living a healthier lifestyle? So it's for your job to cast the vision. When we look at skills, this was a major investment. As a matter of fact, when we launch, we don't always do this workshop. It's an additional fee. Obviously, there's some expense with us traveling out here and being out of the office. And your team invested in us being here to provide the skills that you need to successfully launch this. We also are going to provide a lot of follow-up training. But it's really in your hands when you get back to your facility to give them confidence that you're going to provide them the skills they need to be successful. So if you cast a great vision and you provide them the skills, you're on the right track. The third element is probably something we struggle with more often than not, and that's incentives. In the for-profit world, this is very easy. As a matter of fact, 24E that we just partnered with in Birmingham said, oh, we're not going to have a problem keeping people motivated. And I said, why? They said, because their salary is directly connected to the performance of the organization. So they have a base salary, but they have an incentive structure that they get bonuses or compensated for the performance. It's a for-profit that some operators have. Most of the people we work with don't have that. And so we have to think creatively about how are we going to incentivize our staff. Incentives are important. They don't always have to be monetary. So you need to think creatively. I have a great blog post that talks about incentives and talks about the currencies that we have that we don't often think about, the currencies of incentives. So that's something I can definitely share with you, but incentives are going to be important. Resources are not just the information that you're going to need because it falls more on your skills, but resources are, do I have enough iPads? Do I have access to customer service? Do I have access to leadership when I have questions? So we're going to make sure that you guys feel like you have the resources that you need and the resources in place, and a lot of thought has been given to that. And then the last section is going to be the action plan. So we need to know when you go back to your centers, you should be equipped to be able to tell them, this is the training timeline. This is who needs to attend this training. This is who needs to attend that training. You'll be very clear about the timeline. Nothing gives people more anxiety about not knowing when things are supposed to happen. So let's look at, if we're missing any one of these elements, what the outcome can be. If we're missing vision, more often than not, you'll start hearing confusion. I don't know why we're doing this. Why are we doing this again? You'll hear lots of those types of questions. People are looking kind of squinted-eyed at you going, what is this all about? Why are we doing it? Who is this supposed to serve? Has anybody ever been involved with an initiative where you just felt confused most of the time, that you weren't sure what was going on or why you were doing it? Yeah, I see a lot of head nods. Somebody wants to raise their hand. Nobody wants to out themselves. Let's say that you have the vision, you have incentives, the resources, and an action plan, but you never really equip staff on how to do it. But say you get a new operations software and you don't get trained on it. That immediately creates anxiety. I understand why it's important. I understand that I'm going to be rewarded for doing this well. I have the resources, I have the software, and I have the action plan, but I don't know how to do it. So it's critically important that we have that training, and it creates anxiety if you don't. Without incentives, change can happen, but it's slow, okay? And it's kind of like the different models of parenting. Do you reward kids when they do stuff right, or are you just going to punish them when they do things wrong, or are you going to do some of both? Incentives accelerate change. And so if you want to accelerate change, and we know how important this is, we heard some conversation earlier about the salaries and everything else that's going on right now. If you want change faster, incentives, and they don't have to be monetary, but incentives matter. You have all of that, but the resources are missing. You can't get access to support when you have questions. You can't get access you don't have enough technology, you don't have enough tablets, whatever it is. That's going to create frustration, but as you're trying to follow through, you have everything else that you need, you're just missing that piece. And then, of course, if you're missing an action plan, you're going to have a lot of false starts. So you'll have one facility that's out in front, and they're leading it, and they're doing it, they get it, because they figured out the action plan, they figured out what the steps were, but everybody else is kind of lost and doesn't know where to start. So a lot of times it's that failure to launch mentality, where you'll have some people who are out there applying and some people that are just paralyzed and don't know what the first step is. So it's really important that that action plan gets communicated back down to the team. And so a lot of times, the first thing that needs to happen is you have to look through and say, okay, what's day one going to look like? What's the first thing I'm going to do tomorrow? And I say that we just have to identify what the first step is and then what the next step is. So after you complete that first step. And so I just put here as an example, this is really meant to spark some conversation at your table. What needs to happen? And this is just an example. A department meeting with all staff to brief them on the vision and the timeline, et cetera. Everything that you learned here today, at some point, you're gonna wanna go back to your facility and meet with the people who were involved and do some of the work that we did here today, cast the vision. What does that need to look like? I'm gonna show you the customer page. That's a great place to get resources for that step. You need to focus on the vision, the training dates, the timeline, incentives, and you need to talk about all that in the first meeting. So who's going to be responsible? That's the next thing you need to figure out. Perhaps a site manager with somebody who's going to assist them and support them in this meeting. What's the timeline? Within 2 weeks of MMU, that's what you're doing here today. And then what's the status? Right now it hasn't been scheduled, the agenda has not been written. So this is a very simple grid that you can use to think about what is the immediate next step when I leave here today? What needs to happen? Who's going to be responsible for doing it? And how are we going to make sure we've completed it? And then marking the status, because there's going to be some immediate next steps. So the first thing that I wanted to do before you break into some conversation about this is to show you our customer page. That's where you're going to find a lot of resources that you're going to need in your next step. We have some PowerPoint presentations. We even have meeting agendas. We have lots of resources. Some of them you're going to look at and you're going to say, perfect, I'm going to use this just as it is. I'm going to print it. I've got everything I need. Some of you are going to look at it and say, I'm going to use this slide and that slide. I don't want to use the rest of it. I don't need all that. Or you might look at the meeting agenda and say, this is perfect. I'm going to run it just like this. Or it may just inspire you to write your own agenda. But in any case, we want you to have the resources we've learned over time. That just getting this meeting together and getting your staff educated is probably going to be the biggest hurdle. And we want to help you get through it. So bear with me. I'm going to pull it up for you and show you how to access some of that. There we go. Okay, we're going to share this link electronically with you, so you can write it down if you want. It's a password-protected page. We'll also share with you the password. It's engage.mobilefit.com, and then / I always call it front slash, not forward slash. I do it backwards. Customer-page. So hopefully you can see that, and the password is MBLFT, it's MBLFT, all capital, and then customer. So again, we'll share this with you. But this is where we have our new customer launch guide, which is going to be what we want to look at today. The account setup has already been handled by your leadership, so they're working closely with us to set up your account. The training schedule is on there. That's not your hard dates. That's just a general idea of what a training schedule typically looks like. Brian, I'm sure, will share with you the training dates. Internal communication is where you want to focus. Internal communication is how you communicate back with your staff. This is where the PowerPoints are, meeting agendas, resources, all kind of information you can use to communicate and cast a vision at your individual sites. So when you're thinking about what does that first meeting look like, this is a great place to go for resources. Marketing, I believe, will probably be handled centrally. Are you guys going to handle that centrally or at the site level?
Yes.
Centrally, so that will be something that will be handled centrally for you guys. And then you guys have your own process map and KPIs. So this is just a sample of kind of our best practices, but you guys have that in your hand today. And then the resource tab is invaluable. That's going to take you to our resource page. We have ebooks and white papers and videos that have been downloaded thousands of times and read by people in all across the industry. So you guys have access to those for free. So use the resource link to read some of this material. It's also things that you can share with your staff. So we've got an ebook on the science of member retention. We've got an ebook on bringing new members on board. We've got some videos. We've got a great blog. So that's going to connect you to those. In the middle section here, you have your tutorial videos. You're going to go through that with Stacy. But I know some of you in here want to get a jump on it. You want to kind of see into the system. How many of you want to see into the system and see what it really, really does? Right? I know some of you are going to go on there and look. So just go ahead and you know, satisfy your curiosity. Stacy's going to go through it with you, with your own branch, but you can check it out. And then we have resources by position. So if you're in a leadership position, you can look and see what resources might be relevant for you. And then we also have a place for you to download the apps. You can't get into the apps until you have login information, which Stacy will issue to you. So the tutorial videos right now are the best way for you to see into the software if you're curious. And then the last section is our development blog, and it's got that white font that's kind of hard to see. But that's where we post all of our releases. And so there's lots of software companies that build things and then just sell it, and they never update it, they never improve it. As a matter of fact, lots of people sell things they didn't even build. So they buy it and then they just sell it and let it run its course. We are constantly reinventing and adding features. And so the development blog is a great place to just go look and see what's been released lately and kind of what our release schedule is. And as you become customers, that's a place you'll want to go check and look for new stuff. So this is a great resource for you guys. Again, engage.mobilefit.com, /customer/page. And so you guys can check that out. We'll send it to you in a link. The last thing you're going to do today, in the last 10 minutes or so that we have together, is you're going to work with your team to develop the immediate next steps. So what is the immediate next step that you want to do with your facility to kind of help them to get involved with this, to help them understand what's coming? Because if their first step is attending a webinar training, you haven't done what you're supposed to do, because they don't even know what they're attending it for, right? So you want to really help cast the vision for them to understand what this initiative is all about. So I'm going to give you guys a
question.
So I heard some great conversations, walking around. How many of you have an immediate next step? How many of you have an immediate next step? Like, you know, what needs to happen next? One, two, three, four, five? Okay, I'm going to make everybody who doesn't run last, because that was the assignment. That's what you guys are supposed to do. Okay, she said, no, we got it. Okay, so I just wanted to do a couple housekeeping things. There's going to be some communication. The communication's already come out about the web-based trainings, where you're online with our customer service. She's awesome, Queen Stacy Alvey. She's going to be using your live account and showing you how to use it with your account, not like a fake account or a dummy account or screenshot. She's going to be taking you through your account. So Leon has already sent some information about that, but we know it's been a little while and about who should attend what, so we're going to send it again, just so you'll have clarification on who needs to attend what. There's usually two different times offered for each training topic. That way you've got some flexibility with your staff. So you've got this time or that time, and they'll pick one. You're also going to have an opportunity where Brian's going to be looking for some representation from each site to be part of an implementation team. Stop pointing fingers back there. That's not nice. Now, I'll tell you this story, and you can take it for what it's worth. When I was with the Birmingham Y, I was went back part-time after having two children, thinking I wasn't going to have a career. I was going to make my husband handle that part, and I was just going to work for fun. Several years later, I ended up supervising member engagement in 9 branches, so you know how that works, right? When you're good at something and you enjoy it, you tend to excel. So, the way that I got from where I was to where I ended up, when a lot of my peers were trying to get to the same place, I wasn't really looking to be there, that's just where I ended up, was that I saw opportunities for what they were, and I took hold of them every time. When we say that there is an opportunity to be the representative from your facility to head up a strategic initiative that has the potential to be a huge revenue play for your entire organization, believe that not only is that a professional opportunity for you as part of this organization, it's a personal opportunity too. Because you're going to get to work with some information that's a higher level than what you probably normally have access to. You're going to get to look at numbers and trends that you normally wouldn't have access to. So I encourage you to embrace that opportunity if you're tapped for that resource, for that opportunity, because it's what I enjoyed the most, and it's where I learned the most, was having those opportunities. I know that's not for everybody, but I just want to encourage you guys. So our immediate next step is we're going to make sure you get the training information you need. Brian's next step is he's going to be tapping some of you for that leadership opportunity in this initiative. And then we're going to be available from here on out. There's a lot of technology companies that give you one point of contact for an organization this size, and that's who gets to come to us and ask questions. We've never had that policy. So my email address is kelly@mobilefit.com. Spell it K-E-L-L-Y. I'm here as a resource for you. Rich is available also. His is likewise rich@mobilefit.com. As you get to know Stacy, she's available. We will know and answer the phone personally if you call. We expect there to be a lot of questions in the months to come. That's completely normal, so don't ever be shy. Sometimes we may just direct you to the person, your association or organization is responsible for that, but most times we'll answer your question right when you call. So I just want to say that and let you guys know that it's been a pleasure working with you today. We've enjoyed our time with you, and we look forward to working with you in the coming months.
Can you speak to that part about when you went back to work? When you went back to work after
that? Oh, repeat the part where I went back to work? And then I ended up now, working full time and working some huge initiatives. So it was an awesome ride, and I loved it. And we worked in a very resource restricted environment. So when you guys say, we don't have this to do that, we don't have that, I used to tell people that I was the person that came with the solution to the problem. There is an infinite number of people that can find problems. The people that can find the solution to the problem are the leaders. That's who you want to promote, because they're the person that's going to make your life easier, not the person that can find the problems. There's lots of those. So if you find a challenge, there'll be obstacles, there'll be challenges. Be the person that finds a solution, and you'll be invaluable, not just at your site, but to the organization as a whole. And I was just really good at finding solutions, and so that's how I ended up where I was.
So you have positive attitude, can do, found solutions, and December of this year. Anybody want to speak up for Spring Hill? When is Mr. Cooper? October 19th, 2019, or next year. Patty, when are you?
In a couple of years.
Okay. So, the folks, as I said in the beginning, this is the most important thing. The biggest thing that I've seen in the 7 years I've been with this agency. The people that buy in, have a positive, can-do attitude, are the people that will always advance. It's not something new, they always have. If you're looking for advancement, come with the solutions, come with a positive attitude, come with